land. True patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O
Please bow your heads and close your eyes for prayer. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, hallowed is thy name. We come before you today with hearts of thanksgiving and praise, honoring you for your guidance, provision, and safety thus far. Father, we thank you so much for our time here together, for all the friends we have made, for all the days of laughter and fun, and all the times of great discovery and learning. We thank you for all who have given of their energy and skill so that we can graduate today, our teachers, our mentors, our family and loved ones. We thank you for them and give them to you in prayer.
As this chapter on our lives closes, so a new one begins. We present ourselves like an open book before you. Come inscribe your words of life into our lives. Fill our minds with your thoughts. Fill our bodies with your strength. Fill our hearts with your dreams, that we might eternally love and serve you this day and every day. So, gracious Lord, on this day set apart for our graduation ceremony, we invite your presence to dwell among us and to direct the service. We pray that your vision for this day will come to pass and that your will be done. We ask in no other name of Jesus. Amen.
Family, friends, teachers, honorable guests, and last but not least, the graduating class of 2020. We would like to welcome you all to our graduation ceremony.
Most of us have been together about 10 years, others only one. Nevertheless, the experiences we have shared has given us memories for a lifetime. We've shared in joys and sorrows, and through the ups and downs, we have developed a deep faith in Jesus.
Today, this celebration bears witness our resilience in these unprecedented times of COVID-19. Indeed, our hard work and determination has paid off. We look forward in the future with big dreams and great ambition.
We'd like to thank all and extend our gratitude and appreciation to all for your virtual attendance.
This class is destined for greatness.
And we are glad that you are here for one of the major turns in our journey.
The 2020 Grade A graduating class welcomes you.
It was Martin Luther King Jr. who said, "Intelligence plus character is the goal of true education." And so I just want to say on behalf of the Toronto Adventist District School Board, congratulations on achieving this milestone in your educational journey. You have made it successfully through elementary, you've made it through middle school, and now you're in high school. Well, I want to let you know, the world is a little bit different in high school, as you have already started to realize. But you know what? With Christ in the vessel, you will be successful. And so may God bless you as you embark or continue on this aspect of your educational journey. So again, on behalf of the Toronto Adventist District School Board, we just want to say congratulations as you celebrate this milestone. God bless you.
Crawford Adventist Academy's Parent Teacher Association would like to take this time to congratulate the grade 8 graduating class of 2020 and their parents. Job well done. May God continue to bless you as you move forward to a new chapter. Congrats.
Greetings from the Ontario Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. On behalf of the President, Mansfield Edwards, the Secretary, Yakov Biblovich, and Treasurer, Farin Mikkel, I bring a warm welcome. My name is David Forsey, and I am the Assistant Superintendent of Schools. It is a joy to celebrate this occasion with you. It is a time for parents to acknowledge the achievements of their children. It is a crossroads for our graduates. Graduates, as you reflect over your accomplishments and face your fears of tomorrow, remember that at all crossroads, we need to look to the cross of Jesus. Luke says it best in chapter 9, verse 23, when he says, Jesus says, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. Graduates, I encourage you to humble yourselves, pick up your cross daily, and follow Jesus. Remember that Jesus promises us in John 15, 16, that whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name, he will give it to you. Go boldly each day in faith and see that the Lord is good. Remember that at every crossroads in life, look to the cross of Jesus.
Although I am one of a million, I am somebody, and that makes me as good as the other person.
I know there'll be many times when it seems that all odds are against me, and I have to fight one battle after another, but I will not give up because the Bible tells us to.
Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
He giveth power to the faint.
But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor depth, nor height, nor things present, nor things to come, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we're gonna walk it out and move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll isn't quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe, and I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains, take it to its feet and move. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, we have each other. And I'll rise up high like the waves. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it 1,000 times again. For you.
Assistant Superintendent of Education, Mr. David Forsey. Chairman of Toronto Adventist District School Board, Pastor Travis Affleck. JK to 8 Principal, Ms. Judy Bergenhall. Teachers, parents, students, and well-wishers, good evening. It is my privilege to be class president of the Grade 8 graduating class of 2020. We eagerly entered Grade 8 on September 3rd, 2019. We had so many fears and aspirations of what this year was going to be like. Here we are, seniors of junior high, ready to take on the challenges, or so we thought. We were looking forward to fundraisers, auto trips, and graduation. Little did we know, our year would get turned upside down, literally. COVID-19 entered, and the result of that was extended March break, online school, Ottawa trip canceled, and a traditional graduation canceled. As a matter of fact, it felt like our whole lives were canceled. You may be thinking, this poor class, but let me share with you some of our memories. The first big thing our class did was our fundraiser. We could have done a bake sale or any other basic thing, but our unique class decided to host a basketball tournament. Although it was not easy, with the help of Mr. Ambrose and all the different volunteers, we were able to pull it off. This was a big accomplishment because we were able to raise over $1,000 for graduation and our sweaters. Then there was skiing and snowboarding. From the bus ride to the actual trip was all around fun. I remember a couple of us falling from racing, annoying our instructors, and just having a good time. Thank you, Mr. Moore, for putting that trip together. Looking back, I also remember us playing Uno, speed, and two ball at recess. I remember the 8M kids asking 7M 8 kids for some of the food they made in home economics class, or stressing over how to work the different programs on the computer. I also remember when the boys were struggling to sew in a straight line, but eventually they sort of got it. We moved on to online school, which just kept on going and going. This had its challenges as we were forced to adapt quickly. Some of us did not mind, but some of us missed the direct social interaction with others, and we wondered when this would all be over. It seemed like the fun parts of school were taken away, but we had to make it work. As we stand here today, we can say that by God's grace and hard work, we made it. I would like to thank the executive team for their hard work this year. To our Vice President, Zipporah Petgrave, I want to thank you for taking charge of the fundraiser. To our Secretary, Talia Burton, thank you for keeping things organized and easy to find. Lastly, to our Treasurer, Jenny Lee, I want to thank you for keeping count of the dues and staying on top of everything. Without the team, I don't know what I would have done. I also want to thank Ms. Bergenhall, Ms. Godso, Ms. Chichester, and Mr. Mora. Without you, we would not be able to stand here successfully graduating Grade 8. We thank you for the sacrifice and commitment to us. Also, thank you to Ms. Ann Sable, Mr. Brown, Mr. Andrade, and Mr. Ambrose for teaching us and for your dedication. We have reached a huge milestone in our lives. Let us not take it lightly. As it is our time in our history where we are witnessing a global pandemic, it is also time in our history where we are seeing firsthand the injustice of African Americans and the Black Lives Matter global protests. So, grade 8 graduating class of 2020, as you celebrate your well-deserved accomplishments and achievements and move on to the next chapter, in the words of Michelle Obama, don't be afraid, be focused, be determined, be hopeful and empowered. Thank you.
Faith and I are very excited to introduce our speaker for our grade 8 graduation. He has a very long and complicated last name, so we just call him Pastor Sam.
Pastor Sam was born and raised in Montreal before pursuing studies at Burman University in Alberta.
While at Burman, he studied biology with the hopes of becoming a doctor. However, although he did very well academically, he did not find true happiness in that field.
Jeremiah 29 verse 11 tells us that God has a plan for each of his children, and God had a plan for Pastor Sam, because after working one summer at Foothills Camp in Alberta, he finally accepted God's call to ministry.
After graduating from Burman University in 2019, he was called to the Toronto Conference as a youth and young adult ministry pastor at Willowdale Church. He is learning about being a pastor that there is more than preaching sermons and chairing meetings. It is about building a meaningful relationship with the people and helping them grow.
He accepted that even though he wanted to help people physically by being a doctor, God wanted him to help them spiritually instead. Pastor, the graduating class is honored that you have accepted to be our speaker. We really like you because you have an amazing personality and a good connection with the students at Crawford.
Pastor Sam, we love you and thank you for the times that you take of your busy schedule to make time for us.
We pray that God blesses your ministry as you draw young people closer to him. Now, we await a word from you.
Thank you so much, Zipporah and Faith, for that wonderful introduction. I just want to extend a warm welcome to all of our virtual viewers and, of course, to the graduating class of 2020. Let me start off by saying how honored I am to be here. You know, I'm so blessed to enjoy this wonderful moment with all of you guys. Let me start off by asking you guys a question. Do you remember what life was like in September of 2019? Well, let's see. To me, well, everything was going pretty normal. I was born in September, so I was celebrating my birthday on the 29th, but you know me, our generation, we have birthday months. We don't have birthdays. So I was celebrating my birthday the whole month. What else? The Raptors were fresh off of their championship, right? So we were celebrating that. The new season was about to start. Right, social distancing, well, that wasn't a thing. And people weren't walking around with masks all the time. What else? Oh, right, you guys all started your school year in grade 8, your final year. Now, how many of you guys thought that you would be completing that year online? For a good chunk of it. Anyone? Or better yet, who thought that you would be having your graduation 2 months into your first year of high school? I'm sure none of you did, but yet here we are, masks and all, social distancing, having a virtual graduation ceremony in the middle of a global pandemic. But that being said, you guys made it. I mean, you've already started grade 9. You all earned this moment, though. Why? Because you continued, despite the circumstances. Trust me when I say that none of us went through what you did when we were in grade 8. So let me start off by saying how proud I am of each and every one of you for getting to this moment. I had the privilege of getting to know you all last year by being your speaker at your week of prayer. Way back in November, almost a year ago, and then by being your interim chaplain as well. I remember telling you guys to go to class all the time and bothering you guys in the hall and in gym class. which made my experience at Crawford very, very fun. So thank you, class of 2020. You know, when I was told the aim for today, I immediately recognized it as the famous quote from Winston Churchill: success is not final, failure is not fatal, but it's the courage to continue that counts. Now, I don't know about you guys, but when it comes to words like success and failure, I tend to gravitate towards success. And I know I'm not the only one in that category. I'd be surprised to hear if one of you told me that you'd rather fail than succeed. It's normal to prefer success. I know that it's so easy to get discouraged by failure. At first glance, when we're going through these massive amounts of pain that's associated with failure, it can seem horrible. It could suck. As the walls come crashing in and your world starts crumbling down right before your very eyes, you know, there's little that anyone can tell you in those moments. You know, the fact is that we spend so much time being afraid of failure, when in fact, we need to welcome it. We need to embrace failure with open arms because it does far more to serve us than it does to hinder us. Failure allows us to reach new understandings. Plain and simple, it's quite possibly the most important tool in a successful person's arsenal. The truth is, life is what you make of it. Whatever you focus on will surely come to fruition. You can allow failure to be fatal. Sure you could. That's obvious, but that's your choice. You can look at the person who's entirely given up because they failed and they turn to other sources of self-therapy, whether it's drugs or whether it's alcohol or anything else for that matter. And then you might see how failure might be fatal. But most people don't give up after failure. Sure, they have to go through those stages of grief with failure, whether it be denial or depression or anger or acceptance, but that's all part of the learning process that's associated with failure. But that's the last and final stage, where they accept their failure and use it for good. And that is when the real magic begins to happen. They embrace failure. They don't take it as the final nail in the coffin. It isn't fatal, it's the beginning. Failure is the starting line, not the finish of the race. Through failure, you guys will reach new understandings and realization about what it takes to succeed. You know, Henry Ford once said that failure is simply the opportunity to begin again, this time more intelligently. That's all. You just need to start again, but this time with a different approach and more knowledge behind your belt. Because here's the thing about success. The part about failure is that most of us are so fixated on success. We're so obsessed with succeeding that we tend to compromise certain values to get ahead. We don't care what it takes. We only care about winning. But clearly not everyone thinks this way, but I know I used to. But the problem, I realize that the problem with that mentality is that you can enjoy success briefly, but it won't last forever. It won't stick around for long. That success, it won't be final, it won't be long-lasting, but that's all a part of the learning process. It's all a part of how life works in mysterious ways to guide us in the direction that we're intended to go. But reaching those fundamental understandings about success and failure can only come through time. It's part of the meaning of life. We're meant to discover those things. We're meant to reach these realizations in life in order to focus on the right things rather than focus on the wrong things. That's why Winston Churchill once said that success is not final, failure is not fatal, but it's the courage to continue that counts, because it does take true courage to keep pushing forward, especially in the face of failure, especially when you were succeeding in the past and you're no longer succeeding anymore. It takes a lot of courage to push forward. But that's precisely what you have to do in order to succeed. I'm not talking about that basic kind of success that we might all experience at one point or another. I'm talking about true success that comes from building or creating something that can help the world or help someone's life. Okay, so success clearly isn't final. And failure isn't fatal because any of the millions of people who achieved wild success can tell you that much. I mean, ask Beyonce, ask Michael Jordan, ask Bill Gates. So, what's the right approach, Pastor Sam? What's the right way to act and to behave? How can we achieve our goals without getting so discouraged along the way? Simply put, how many of you guys ever watched Forrest Gump? My guy Forrest Gump will tell you himself, life is like the proverbial box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Anything can happen. You'll go through the good moments. You'll have a blast. You'll be blessed for a bit. And then things might not go your way at times. You'll get knocked down. You'll fail at times. You'll fall. Bad things can and will happen, and it will happen often. However, life is also what you make of it. Failure isn't fatal when you look at it the right way. Everything is about how you respond. Everything's about how you look at events that happen in your life. If you take them a certain way, you'll feel one way. If you look at it another way, you'll feel another way. So you have to take things with a grain of salt. Look to your faith. Look to God. You know, one thing someone always told me growing up is that no matter what you're going through, if God wakes you up in the morning, he's not finished with you. There's purpose for your pain. You guys have said it before. The Bible is full of promises that can pick you right back up when you fall. You guys have already entered a new chapter in your lives by entering high school. And it will come with its own challenges. Assignments are gonna get harder. The due dates are always gonna stay the same. Procrastination will be more tempting. You will experience successes. You will experience failures. And you'll experience everything in between. But regardless of what you go through, I know truly that each and every one of you will be okay. Ask me why. I heard you. Well, for one, you have God in your corner. He's always there for you to lean on no matter what. His promises are always there for you to cling on to. You have teachers who are here to support you. You have your parents. You have your loved ones there to carry you all the way. And finally, you guys have already dealt with adversity and have come out on top. So whatever challenge this upcoming year throws at you, continue, push forward, persevere. Congratulations to each and every one of you. You know I have nothing but love for you, and I'm so proud of who you guys are and the amazing things I'm going to hear about all of you in the future. God bless.
The school year 2019 to 2020 began with a bang. Parents came, prayed, and sang that God would bless our year and always be near. As grade eighters, we started with great expectation. We could see grade eight graduation 10 months away, shimmering in the distance. Getting closer and even brighter with every passing day. And oh, let's not forget to say that September 2019 had markings every way.
Markings that read, your last year in junior high.
What a big sigh of relief. We are now sitting at the top. The top of our division's chain.
Older and wiser and able to say
to the younger grades, we've been there, done that.
As time passed, we could hear the beckoning sounds emanating from the small office by the T.
They seemed to coincide with the words of our teachers. Before you know it, high school will be your domain. And sad to say,
we would be relegated to the bottom of the chain.
Again, at the bottom of the chain.
Oh, but this time, the bottom looks different.
We are free as a bee to create a world for all to see.
That we have learned to manage our time and resist the temptation to lie.
We know the importance of honesty and doing our best at all times.
The question is, why are we graduating only now? This is October, not June 2020.
To this day, we can't ascertain
how a tiny strain called coronavirus could bring our world to a screeching halt and rob us of our trip to Ottawa and our traditional graduation ceremony.
Yes.
Today, we are already in high school,
but we are grateful for a graduation like no other.
Oh yes, we made it.
Made it because of our teachers.
Made it because of our interim principal and principal.
Made it because of our family and friends.
Made it because of our drive to succeed.
Made it above all because of our God.
Today we borrow from the words of Marvin Sapp to say to God,
we are stronger, we're wiser, we're better, much better. When we look back over all you brought us through, we can see that you were the one we held on to, and we never, never would have made it. Oh, we never could have made it. Never could have made it without you. Thank you, God, for seeing us through.
Assistant Superintendent of Education, Mr. David Forsey, School Board Chair, Pastor Travis Affleck, Principal of the High School Division, Mr. Andon Boyce, distinguished graduates, relieved faculty, proud parents, supportive family, friends, and well-wishers. The grade 8 graduates of the class of 2020 hail from the home of the world's fastest sprinters, Jamaica, the country of the bald eagle, the United States, and from the true north, strong and free, Canada. There are 10 males and 17 females, and together they make an amazing kaleidoscope. This group possesses amazing verbal skills that they use every second of the day, in and out of season. As well, they are critical thinkers, high-spirited, opinionated, march to their own drumbeat, and can keep you entertained all day. Nevertheless, they are kind, caring, and considerate, and all in all, just incredible. Each one unique in their own right, gifted, talented, and full of possibility. These are our world's future gymnastic coaches, businessmen, lawyers, mechanical engineers, psychologists, nurses, chefs, billionaires, oncologists, zoologists, pediatricians, doctors, musicians, and professional athletes. This year, the Lord has blessed us with 27 graduates. Of this number, 8 have attended CAA from junior kindergarten to the present, and 1 will graduate in absentia. Principal Boyce, I would like to hand over these 27 young people to you as they pursue studies in the high school division. They belong to you now, so fasten your seatbelt and enjoy the next 4 years of the journey. I stand proud at this moment as I pass my students to you and the high school staff. I request that your faculty take time and be patient with each of them because they will frustrate you. But under it all is a flower waiting to bloom and a life waiting to unfold. They stand together at this moment, determined to achieve success through service. For this group, success is not final, failure is not fatal, but is the courage to continue that counts. Grade 8 class of 2020, continue to be steadfast on the journey of success, and when knocked down, get up. dust yourself off, and keep striving with the help of God. I believe you can. Assistant Superintendent of Education, I present 27 students that have followed the prescribed course of study and will be included in today's graduation ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, Crawford Adventist Academy, COVID-19, Grade 8 graduating class of 2020. Rochelle Rihanna Thompson. Justin Caden Gomez, high honors. Hanos Yatbarek Alamayo, high honors. Frederick Alexander Nichols, high honors. Joshua Aiden Peterson. Rihanna Paul Samuels, honors. Talia Burton, highest honors, English, Math, and Social Studies Award. Jayla Campbell, highest honors. Jordana Dallas Ruth Donaldson, high honors. Joshua Michael Henriquez. Lauren Victoria Gilbert, highest honors, English, French, Math, Science, Social Studies, and Bible Awards. Trichet Monet St. Rose Honors. Keaton Miles Thompson. Doyle Caden Lewis Balfour, High Honors. Micaiah Antonia Rose. Jada Jordana Francis, Highest Honors, French Award. Rihanna Marie Burkett Phillips. Cameron Jack Conroy, Highest Honors, Erica Brown English Award, Physical Education, Science, Social Studies, and Bible Awards. Danielle Tiana Mitchell, High Honors. Callum Jean-Luc Edward Wright, Physical Education Award. Savannah Elsie Holligan Lewis. Thank you. Nasaya Moisha Alexander.
Zipporah Naomi Petgrave, Highest Honors, Physical Education Award. Zipporah Naomi Petgrave, Highest Honors, Physical Education Award.
Zaria Donald, High Honors. And Faith Ivana Citrum. I charge you, graduates, to put on the whole armor of God. Keep the breastplate of righteousness on. Be ready with the sword of the Spirit. Raise the shield of faith. Be grounded in the gospel of peace. Wear the belt of truth. Grade 8 graduates, truth, righteousness, peace, faith, and salvation, God's word and prayer, are more than just words. Learn how to apply them because you will need them throughout your life. Finally, class of 2020, with all of the full armor of God on, it is entirely possible for you to be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. So go boldly forward. Be prepared always. Follow the path of success. Strive to be extraordinary and be all that God has created you to be.
A tribute to our parents.
We'll never take for granted how greatly we've been blessed. For when it comes to parents, mom and dad, you are the best.
You nurtured and protected us and taught us with great care. And every time I've needed you, you were always there.
If you could look into our hearts, how quickly you would see the special place you hold there and how much you mean to me.
May you receive the blessings you are so deserving of for your caring, your sharing, and each sacrifice of love.
And may you carry in your hearts these words forever true. No parents anywhere on earth could be more loved than you.
Parents of the grade 8 graduating class of 2020, thank you, because we could have never made it without you. We are everything we are because you loved us. Clearly, you were the wind in our sails. You raised us up so we can stand on mountains. You raised us up to walk on stormy seas.
We are strong when we are on your shoulders. You raise us up to more than we can ever hope to be. Parents, we want to thank you for your love and appreciation. Give yourselves a round of applause and accept our virtual hugs and kisses as we celebrate our graduation.
I am down, and oh, my soul so weary. When troubles come, let my heart burden be. And I am still, and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
At this time, we would like to acknowledge the students who have been at Crawford for 10 full years. But I don't only want to recognize the students, I want to recognize the parents who trusted us with their babies for so long. I also want to recognize the fact that you have spent thousands and thousands of dollars that you didn't even know that you had. You could be rich right now, but you have chosen to invest it in these children, and for that, we thank you. Lauren Gilbert, Mr. and Mrs. Gilbert. And parents, while you sit on the sofa at home, I want you to stand up when your child's name is called. Talia Burton, Mr. and Mrs. Lance Burton. Frederick Nichols, Pastor and Mrs. Nichols. Micaiah Rose, Mr. and Mrs. Rose. Justin Gamez, Mr. and Mrs. Gamez. Cameron Conroy, Mr. and Mrs. Conroy. Joshua Henriquez, Mr. and Mrs. Henriquez. Hayden Lewis Balfour, Mrs. Lewis Balfour, and Mr. Balfour. It is my pleasure to award the Campus Ministries Award to two young men, Joshua Henriquez and Justin Gamez.
For excellence in citizenship, we award Jada Francis, Jordana Donaldson, and Frederick Nichols. I would like to acknowledge four amazing young people from this graduating class. This is the Leadership Medallion, and they were the student advisors that came by during the week to help us out in the office. And definitely, I can see strong traits of leadership. I encourage you to keep on the trend that you have begun. Be a leader and not a follower. Lauren Gilbert. Talia Burton. Zipporah Petgrave. Caden Lewis Balfour.
This year has two most improved students in 8M. The first is a very athletic student. As the year progressed, she became much more serious about her schooling. From acting out the book entitled Days of Terror to dancing in front of the camera for a cultural study, this year's most improved is Rihanna Burkett Phillips. This year's second most improved from 8M is a remarkable student. At times, she has questioned her ability. However, as the year progressed, it became very evident that a large increase of effort was applied. The second most improved was Nasiah Alexander.
The student I would like to recognize as the most improved student is a student that I have seen grown holistically. While he is shy, he made strides in expressing himself orally and in writing. As the year progressed, he became more confident in sharing his perspectives and opinions during class discussions. The recipient of the Most Improved Student Award is Micaiah Rose.
The Handysides Memorial Award is given to a student or students who make great ambassadors for our school and represent our school well. The Handysides Memorial Award is given to Zaria Donald and Rihanna Burkett Phillips.
In this beautiful treasure chest, you will definitely find very unique memories, truly many a kind. Some students have put it together back in grade 7 with no delay to be presented very proudly on this actual graduation day. So here I am being obedient, fulfilling their desire, making their wish come true, so I wouldn't be called a liar. As I call your precious name, come up and claim your treasure. Keep it as long as you would like. Old 7M class, it's been a pleasure. If your name is not called, students, come by my office this week to reclaim your contribution. Happy graduation to all of the students. Jaden Mason was a little girl who had attended Crawford years ago, but unfortunately, due to a serious illness, she died at the age of 10. She was considered to be my niece, as I am very close to her mother, and I honestly still miss her greatly. She would have completed her third year of post-secondary education this year. In her honor, we always give a grade 8 student a Jaden Mason Benevolent Scholarship. The person is chosen based on similar qualities that Jaden had possessed: free-spirited, enthusiastic, a very conscientious and straight-A student, a lover of all colors, and a student who has given their heart to the Lord through baptism. The student who was chosen this year is described by her classmates as energetic, willing, a serious A student, creative, artistic, and fun to be around. She too has been baptized. The grade 8 student who will be receiving the Jaden Mason Benevolent Scholarship is none other than Zipporah Petgrave.
Thank you.
This year's salutatorian is a very hardworking student. In class, she loved to participate. When a question was asked, you could be sure that her hand would shoot up. She always submitted excellent projects. Her writing was always eloquent, clear, and to the point. Not only is she a good student, but she's funny. Her video projects were always filled with humor and made the class laugh. It seems her and her friend Faith were always engaged in laughter or some sort of inside joke. Her hard work earned amazing marks throughout her courses. This year's salutatorian is Zipporah Petgrave with an average of 93%.
The student in grade 7, M8, that attained the second highest overall average of 95% is a student that has demonstrated excellent learning skills and work habits. In my interactions with her over the past 2 years, I observed her commitment to learning. To me, she saw learning in grade 8 as a means to broaden her scope in academia and set her on a path that would lead to the attainment of her goals. Even when we shifted to online classes in late March due to COVID, this student was usually the first to turn in her assignments and was one of the first to log in when we met online as a class. This student one day wants to achieve her life dream of becoming a doctor. In class, I wanted to remind her of her dream, and so sometimes I would call her doctor. You will find out in a while. This evening, I would like to introduce to you the student with the second highest average, overall average, of 95%, Miss Jada Francis, the student who dreams to become Dr. Francis one day. In keeping with our custom here at Crawford Adventist Academy during graduation, I would like to virtually recognize Jada's parents, Miss Kadeen Lee and Mr. Francis. The 2019-2020 school year was a historic one for grade 7 M8. Why, Mrs. Chichester? You're probably asking. Well, this year, I want to introduce to you two valedictorians for 2020 instead of one. Yes, you heard me right. They both attained an overall average of 97%. I will introduce them to you alphabetically. Our first valedictorian is a student who pays attention to details. She is very meticulous, is not afraid to seek clarification and ask questions, and values excellence. One of the things I admire about this valedictorian is her ability to transfer her learning from one content area to other areas across the curriculum. In addition, she is analytical and thoughtful in her writing. Towards the end of the school year, I asked my students to write an essay on online learning. I invited them to include both the negative and positive aspects of their learning. Here is an extract of what this valedictorian wrote about her online learning. And I quote, "It was very beneficial because I learned new skills and can now find a way to handle changes. I learned how to manage my time well, how to complete assignments and tasks with less help, how to work with others online, how to learn and retain information while learning new topics independently. All very transferable, necessary skills for high school and post-secondary learning." End of quote. She is not only about academics. She can sing, play an instrument, and communicate effectively, to name a few. Please meet our first valedictorian for grade 7M8, Miss Talia Burton. At this time, I want to recognize virtually Talia's parents, Mr. and Mrs. Burton.
Good evening. Assistant Superintendent of Education David Forsey, Board Chairman Pastor Travis Affleck, JK-8 Principal Ms. Judy Bergenhall, Crawford Adventist Academy faculty and staff, graduating class of 2020, proud parents, grandparents, friends, and family, I am honored to be one of the valedictorians for the graduating grade 8 class of 2020. Here I was coming into my last year of junior high. It was the beginning of the school year and I was very nervous. Although I had been in Ms. Chichester's class in grade 7 and I knew of her expectations and requirements, I still felt extremely anxious. Maybe it was because it was my last year of junior high and I knew that my grades were really important this year to prepare for high school. Maybe it was because I knew my family was expecting big things from me. Maybe I expected big things of myself too. But at the same time, I was also excited. Our class was looking forward to our end of year trips to Wonderland in Ottawa. We couldn't wait to miss class and wear no uniform for our 3 ski trips. We were looking forward to all the traditions that go along with the grade 8 experience here at Crawford. So I set my personal and academic goals with high expectations for a good year. The memories of those first few months, along with the ones I had my heart set on making, all faded and were overshadowed as the COVID-19 pandemic took over the school year. Suddenly, we were quarantined at home, having to learn and adapt to new ways of doing things. Remote virtual learning sure was an experience that our class never saw coming. We had a strict schedule to follow because they wanted us to keep our routine, but all I really wanted to do was stay in bed. The struggle of having to still wake up early and sign on to classes and trying to remember that school was not optional just because I wasn't there physically wasn't easy. I'm sure I speak for my class when I say none of us ever thought we'd be doing gym online. My classmates can all tell you that online struggle was real. And the struggle was more than just academics. Our mental resilience was also tested. It was very different for me to be at home and not see my friends every day. Being at home, I missed hanging out with them at lunch and recess. Zoom and Google Meets are just not the same. But as the weeks went by, with prayer, patience, and learning to be flexible, we adjusted to what everyone keeps calling the new normal. I still don't really know what that means. The disruption of COVID-19 has shown many of us how important personal connections are. This school year taught me that school isn't just about completing assignments and writing exams. It's about people who are there for you and support you through good and bad. And that's how I'm able to stand here before you today as a valedictorian. So I want to thank my homeroom teacher, Mrs. Chichester, in a special way for always keeping me on track even when I wanted to give up. You always looked out for your students. Even during quarantine, you took the time to visit each of us and bring us a special treat. I also want to thank Ms. Bergenhall for all the times you let me come into your office and help me with whatever I needed for that day. as well as your constant encouragement and always reminding us that with God, all things are possible. I want to thank the other kind teachers and staff that have helped me over the years. I may not have called your name, but you do not go unappreciated. Next, I want to thank my family, my aunts, uncles, cousins, and godparents for their support. I give special thanks to my grandparents who picked me up from school, gave me lunch money, fed me good food after school, sewed my uniforms, and above all, prayed with me and over me. I love you very much. To my immediate family, I know we all had to go through quite the adjustment being in the house 24/7, with each of us on different schedules, trying to find quiet time and personal space to get work done, and of course competing for the best Wi-Fi connection. Though we may have gotten on each other's nerves from time to time, you helped me get through the school year successfully. Tyron and Jada, you are the best brother-sister duo I could ever ask for, and you always support me 100%. Thank you. To my mom and dad, I appreciate you very much. Words cannot express how much you do for me. You make sure that I always do my best and tell me that it's not about getting the best grades, but about doing the best that I can. I thank you for your constant encouragement and support, and I love you very much. Last but certainly not least, I want to thank God for being my protector and source of strength through it all. In closing, I know that we can do all things through Christ who gives us the strength we need. Thank you.
Our second valedictorian is generally of a quiet disposition. But don't be fooled. He enjoys socializing with his friends. This student is a thinker, pays attention to details, and is able to transfer skills and learning from one content area to others across the curriculum. One of the things I admire in this valedictorian is his ability to effectively communicate his thoughts both orally and in writing. In my opinion, this student is an excellent writer. This in part speaks to the fact that he is a reader, and the world of reading has given him a repertoire of words, perspectives, and styles of writing. Let me open a window slightly into his writing. As part of a science assignment, this student was asked to write about density and buoyancy. Here is a part of his introduction, and I quote, "Why a massive ship floats and a small rock does not is a concept that seemingly makes no sense. However, like all mysteries in science, there is a reasonable explanation. The logic behind a floating object deals with density, buoyancy, and how they affect each other," end of quote. This valedictorian, too, is not only about academics. He can play an instrument and has audiovisual skills. Please meet our second valedictorian for grade 7M8, Master Cameron Conroy. At this time, I want to recognize virtually Cameron's parents, Mr. and Mrs. Conroy.
Hello, everyone. My name is Cameron, and I'm honored to speak to you all today. I'd like to begin by acknowledging all the people that have brought me this far. My parents have always supported me through all my troubles and hardships, and I'd like to say thank you to both of you. I would also like to thank the Crawford teachers that have helped me this past year to succeed and be the best version of myself. But most importantly, I'd like to thank Google, Wikipedia, and copy and paste. Looking back, I'm thankful for all the moments that this class has shared together, whether they were happy ones, stressful ones, or even mistakes that we've made. I'm glad to have experienced them all. Without a doubt, his class has grown and changed, and for the better. We've come from being unable to pronounce sh properly to launching into high school. All my life, it felt like this moment would never come. It always felt so distant and unattainable. Going into high school seemed so far away, it felt like it would never happen. And all of a sudden, here we are. Ready or not, we're jumping in head first. We have to start thinking about what is going to happen in our lives. What we want to do and who we want to be is something we have to start figuring out now. What legacy are we going to leave behind? It gets worrying thinking about all the expectations we have to live up to and the people we have to impress. You might start to think about all the mistakes you could make and how you might fail. You might think that you aren't going to be enough. The truth is, you will make mistakes and you will fail, but that doesn't make you a failure. Muhammad Ali once said, "If they can make penicillin out of moldy bread, they can sure make something out of you." So don't hesitate to try something. Don't think twice about doing what you love. If you want to make an impact on the world, at the very least, try doing it. You can't change anything by just thinking about it. There is no denying that this world is full of problems. It seems that almost every day there are brand new issues, and every day we hope that someone out there will work to solve it. If there is a person that does rectify that problem, we regard them as a hero. We praise them as if they have done something that we could never hope to do ourselves. The truth is that anyone can make a difference. Anyone can make an impact. So why not you? Why can't you be the hero, the one who changes people's lives? There are a countless number of problems in this world, but there are also a countless number of people capable of fixing it. So why not you? It takes surprisingly little to be the hero in someone's life. You don't have to save a life to be a hero. All you have to do is make a change. Christopher Golden and Nancy Holder once wrote, "A hero is someone who does what must be done and needs no other reason." If you truly want to make a change in the mess of the world that we live in, you have to put in an effort. If you know it is right, go for it. Don't let anyone hold you back. There will be people who try to discourage you and put you down, but it's the getting back up that makes you a hero. If you can push past the people that tell you that you can't do it, you can make a difference in the world. The desire to do the right thing and change lives will make it impossible for anyone to stop you. So the next time you see the world in desperate need of someone to change it, just think to yourself, why can't that be me? Thank you.
This year's valedictorian is a perfectionist. She was never satisfied with 80% or even 90% on a project. She always ensured that every detail and requirement was met. Don't let her soft-spoken demeanor fool you. She is certainly a powerful student. As students were challenged during the spring with online learning, with self-motivation, and staying on top of their assignments, this student excelled. The good work habits and organization developed throughout the year allowed her to thrive online. Not only did she excel academically throughout the entire year, but she was very involved as well. Acting as the grade 8 class president, this year's valedictorian is not only a model student, but a leader as well. With an average of 95.2%, this year's valedictorian is Lauren Gilbert.
Assistant Superintendent of Education, Mr. David Forsey, Chairman of Toronto Adventist District School Board, Pastor Travis Affleck, J.K. Tate Principal, Ms. Judy Bergenhall, teachers, parents, students, and well-wishers, thank you for attending this graduation. Being valedictorian of my class means so much to me. It means that all my hard work and all the stress and challenges I've been through have paid off. They say success does not come easy. It takes a lot of hard work and sacrifice. When I started the school year, I thought that grade 8 was going to be the same as grade 7. But grade 8 took more discipline. I had to get used to exams, which I wasn't ready for. I had to force myself to sit and study. I had to overcome the challenges of online school due to COVID-19. But because I persevered, I humbly stand in front of you as the valedictorian for the grade 8M graduating class of 2020. If I'm being honest, I would not be the valedictorian if it were not for the people that were here throughout my journey. When I first got to Crawford and JK, I was so scared. I cried every day until I felt comfortable. But since then, I have built my second family at this school. I want to take the time to thank all my past teachers. To my elementary teachers, thank you for teaching me all the things that gave me a solid foundation and for teaching me all the life lessons. Thank you to my junior high teachers. To Ms. Marshall, thank you for helping me understand how I learn best, because without that, I don't know how I would have made it through exams. To Ms. Chichester, thank you for teaching me not to doubt myself and to be confident in what I do. To Ms. Godsoe, thank you for teaching me those life skills. To Ms. Antable, thank you for fostering my love for French. To Mr. Moore, thank you for teaching me so many different things and being patient with me. To Ms. Bergenhall, thank you for being such an amazing principal for my past 10 years. Thank you for encouraging me and for just being there. You might not know it, but it meant the world to me. Thank you to my Apple Creek Church family for all your prayers and support. I also want to thank my village for your calls and your hugs. I just want to let you know that it was all appreciated. To my friends and classmates, thank you for the countless times you made me laugh and for encouraging me and supporting me. To my immediate family, words cannot express how much you mean to me. I want to thank my grandparents for always being there for me. Thank you to Auntie Chanel for telling me things how they are. That really helped to mold me into the person that I am. Thank you, Zaire, for always pushing me to be my best self. Auntie Chantel, Uncle Dylan, Christian, thanks for having my back and bringing joy to my life. Mom and Dad, thanks for all the sacrifices you've made for me. I know that it hasn't always been easy, but thank you for doing everything possible to keep me at Crawford. Thank you for your love, countless prayers, and your words of encouragement, especially being a leader and not a follower. Leanne, thank you for your guidance and support. Thank you for giving me advice in many different areas of life and for paving the way that I follow. Even though we annoy each other at times, I know deep down inside you love me. Finally, I want to thank God. Without him, I would be nowhere. Thank you for helping me to be the best version of myself. Thank you for helping me achieve this huge milestone in my life. It's been a long 10 years, but it was all worth it. Grade 8 class of 2020, I leave you with this quote. The road to success is not straight. There's a curve called failure, a loop called confusion, speed bumps called friends, caution lights called family. You will have flats called jobs, but if you have a spare called determination, an engine called perseverance, insurance called faith, a driver called God, you will make it to a place called success. Thank you.
Teamwork is the process of working collaboratively with a group of people in order to achieve a goal. So to all the team members who made this Grade 8 virtual graduation program a success, we extend our appreciation and sincere thanks. Pastor Sam, thanks for your words of wisdom. Mrs. Archer, thank you for blessing us with your creative abilities. The gym looks amazing. Mr. Mora and Mrs. Chichester, in the words of Ray Bolts, thank you for giving to the Lord. We are so glad that you gave. Thank you for giving to the Lord. There are many students' lives that have been changed. Mr. Leroy Brown and Mr. Aravello, thank you for making us sound good, as well as giving our ceremony some pomp and circumstance. Mr. Rambarand and Mr. Reed, thank you for everything that you have done, covering our gym floors and making sure it was ready for us to have our ceremony today. Mr. Dale Brown and Mrs. Marshall, thank you for sharing your musical expertise with our children. Mrs. Marshall, we will miss you in the junior high division. As you go on to the high school division, we ask that the Lord will continue to bless you and that you will continue to impact lives as you have done in our division. To the production team of Maintain Elite,
Lamar Hall, Ryan Jarvis, and Topaz Wadley. We really can't afford to pay you what you deserve, but thank you for your dedication, attention to detail, and for going the extra mile. To our photography team, Mrs. Gomez, Ms. Boyce, and Mrs. Gotso, thank you for stepping in to capture the memories of this day. To you, parents, for believing in Adventist Christian education and for giving CAA an opportunity to partner with you for the success of your children. Special thank you to all of you, and especially to the parents who went the extra mile. To the students, you are indeed wonderful young people. Thank you for doing an excellent job today. Every step, every word, every note was executed to perfection. You are a masterpiece. And finally, to God, thank you for making all things possible. At this time, I have a very special presentation to make to a very special individual. Mrs. Gotso, how can we say thanks? Your contribution to our students is invaluable. Besides this, I would like to especially thank you for standing in the gap during my absence. I know that you dedicated countless hours and many late nights to accomplish each task that needed to be done. Words are inadequate to express our thanks. Therefore, on behalf of the JK-8 division, faculty, and students, please accept this small token of our sincere appreciation. Much love and blessings.
Where's the world that you created, and the stories that you painted with words that made me feel 10 feet tall? Where's the magic in the moonlight, the surprise? Don't see much to inspire much at all. And I'm ready now to fly away, and gravity won't get a thing to say. It's my choice if I get to touch the sky. Is it possible that the square root of impossible is me? It's so possible. Watch me rise high above my obstacles. Watch me become who I'm supposed to be. All the possibilities, 'cause the square root of impossible is possible in me.
We should never be discouraged when we need. Take it to the Lord in prayer.
Let us pray. Lord God, we ask for your mighty hand to be upon all those who have graduated today. Bless our lives from this day forward with goodness and with love. Help us to follow our dreams, to use our gifts wisely, and to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love. This I pray in your name. Amen.
We are not afraid, although we know there's much to fear. We were moving mountains long before we knew we could. Oh, yes. There can be miracles when you believe, though hope is free. It's hard to kill. Who knows what miracles you can achieve when you believe? Somehow you will. You will when you believe.
When fear, when fear so often proves in vain, hope seems.